गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इनफाइनाइट लिमिट ऑफ अ फंक्शन, दैट इज लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू इनफाइनाइट हियर एफ एक्स। दिस टाइप ऑफ लिमिट हाउ विल यू कैलकुलेट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू। सो द मेथड इज दैट इफ यू आर गिवन लाइक लिमिट एक्स टेंड्स टू इनफाइनाइट एंड हियर सम फंक्शन, बाय टेकिंग एन एग्जांपल, if you are given a function like 4x plus 3, 2x plus 7, 4x plus 3 upon 2x plus 7, okay, then how will you calculate, how will you find limit of such type of functions? Now see, if x tends to infinite, so quite clear that since you know something upon infinite will give you 0. Something upon infinite will give you 0. So if x tends to infinite, then what's about 1 upon x? Since x is tending to infinite, so 1 upon x means if this x is infinite, we will put here 1 upon infinite, it will tend to what? 0. And 1 upon x square will also tends to 0. Since x is an infinite, so 1 upon x square again tends to 0. Okay, so how will you solve? So two method. One, either you can divide numerator and denominator by highest power of x, or second method, that is putting or put at the place of x, at the place of x is equal to 1 upon 1. Okay, and if you will put at the place of x is equal to 1 upon y, then put them and y tends to 0. Okay, just make change these two changes, thereafter you can solve the limit as you are solving in previous exercises. So now see, putting at the place of x, so limit x tends to infinite. Now putting at the place of x as 1 upon y. So 4 into 1 upon y plus 3 upon 2 into 1 upon y plus 7. Here y tends to 0. Okay, it implies that limit y tends to 0. See, 4 plus 3y upon y total divided by 2 plus 7y upon y. This y cancel out. It implies that now putting at the place of y as 0, you will get 4 plus 3 into 0 upon 2 plus 0. You will get 4 by 2, that is 2. So this 2 is your answer. Some more questions, sir? Just a x, limit x tends to limit x tends to infinite x cube plus 6x square plus 1 divided by x power 4 plus 3. Okay, so how will you solve? Put x is equal to 1 upon y and y tends to 0. These two changes you can make. So putting here limit x tends to infinite, sorry, y now, y tends to 0. Since at the place of x I am going to put 1 upon y. So 1 upon y cube, okay, plus 6 upon y square plus 1 divided by 1 upon y power 4 plus 3. It implies that limit y tends to 0. Here taking LCM as y cube. So 1 plus 6y plus y cube divided by, here LCM is y power 4. So 3y power 4 divided by y power 4. Now see, this y power 4 cancel out with 1 power will remain left and this y cube. So, this y will go upside, okay. This y will go here, let's imply that limit y tends to 0, here y into 1 plus 6y plus y cube divided by 1 plus 3y power 4. Now putting at the place of y as 0, here 0 into something, it will become 0 upon 1 plus 0. So 0 upon 1 will become 0. So this is your answer. Now one more question.
That is,
all these questions are from 18F. Question number 5, limit x tends to infinity, 5x minus 6 upon under root 4x square plus 9. Okay. So, how will you solve? Again, put x is equal to 1y and y tends to 0. Two changes you need to do. Let's imply that limit y tends to 0. Here 5 by y minus 6 divided by under root 4 upon y square, okay, plus 9. So making it like this, limit y tends to 0. 5 minus 6y upon y divided by, here y square, so under root 4 plus 9y square and divided by y square, that 1 upon y will come here. This y cancel out. Okay. Now putting at the place of y at 0, it implies that y at 0 means 5 minus 6 into 0 divided by under root 4 plus 0. Subtract that y by under root 4, that is 2. So your answer is 5 by 2. Okay. One more question. That is here integration limit. Question number 6. Limit x tends to infinite under root 3x square minus 1 under root 3x square minus 1 minus under root 2x square minus 1, okay, divided by 4x plus 3. 4x plus 3. Now how will you solve it? Just see. Again, just put x is equal to 1 upon y and y tends to 0 in limit. So it implies limit y tends to 0, here under root 3 upon y square minus 1 minus under root 2 upon y square minus 1. Since at the place x is equal to 1 upon y, so x square is 1 upon y square divided by 4 upon y plus 3. Now solving this, what will you get? Limit y tends to 0, 3 minus y square upon y, okay, and here minus 2 under root 2 minus y square upon y, so taking LCM as y, total upon here 4 plus 3y divided by y, this y cancel out. Now putting the value of y at 0, so it implies that under root 3 minus under root 2 divided by 4 plus 0 means 4, under root 3 minus under root 2 In this way, you can solve. This is your answer. Some other questions like question number 9. Limit x tends to 0, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on n divided by n square. Okay. Now see, this is your limit. Here n should be tends to 0. N should be tends to infinite. What is given? Yes, n tends to infinite. So limit n tends to infinite. This 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus till n. So you can put sigma n upon n square. And in class 10. Yes. Value of sigma n. And value of sigma n is. Value of sigma n is n into n plus 1 by 2. So putting this value here, n into n plus 1 by 2, n square, limit n tends to infinite. Simplifying it, here n is this cancel out, you will get n plus 1 upon n. This 2 is outside, 1 by 2, so limit n tends to infinite. Now see, this implies that 1 by 2, here n upon n, that is 1, limit n tends to infinite, 1 plus 1 by 2. Now putting at the place of n as infinite, what you will get? 1 by 2, 1 plus 1 upon infinite. See, 1 by 2, 1 plus 0, that will give you 1 by 2. This is your answer. In this way, you can solve all other questions from this exercise. For any problem, write in comment box, write your problem. Thereafter, I will go through and I will solve your problem. Thank you so much.